Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the music theory series right here at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. Today I'm going to show you a new chord type called a sixth chord, and we rarely talk about it in music production and hip-hop and R&B more so, but not really hip-hop. But it has a really cool purpose to give you that Drake type of sound. So I'll show you how to do it right now. If you're not familiar with me, I'm Game from BusyWorksBeats.com. We've trained over 700,000 producers around the world. Some have gone to work with Drake, Young Thug, Post Malone, YG, Ray Shremmerd, French Montana, NBA Youngboy, Ariana Grande, and a whole bunch of people on the Billboard chart that I'm forgetting the names of, but a lot of people on the Billboard charts. So today I'm gonna show you a music theory strategy, which is how to create chord movement without making the chord feel like it's gone too far away. So this is really good for trap and hip hop because we don't want to, we stay within like a half tone most of the time. Okay. So if you don't know what all that means, it's fine. You don't need to memorize this stuff, but we do have something called chord codes, which I reference a lot. And that's kind of the foundation of our music theory teaching. I teach music theory for music producers, beat makers, songwriters, and I make it easy for you. I don't speak like a different language unless we have to speak Italian or whatever words they speak. Let's create our own language around music theory. So the first step is figuring out the top note. So in this case, it's going to be G. Now, the sixth chord derives from the major chord, and I'll show you what that means. So we're working in reverse now. This isn't the typical way I go about writing chords. I don't usually start with the top. Sometimes I start with the bottom and we work up. But for this video, we're working backwards. So again, this is why chord codes are so powerful. So let's make a major 7 chord code. The chord code for a major 7 is 0-4-7-11. So we're going to take this note, and we're going to assume that it's the top note of some chord. So in this case, we're going to make this the number 11. And then we're going to count down the keyboard. Okay, so it's 11, 10, note by note. Okay, so it's 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. And this will always make the major 7 chord. So now we have the major 7 chord. Okay, the next chord we want it to start on G. Okay, because that's the trick here, is that we're keeping that top note the same, but we're changing the chord so it feels different, but it doesn't feel too far away. And this is really strategic for like Drake style chords. So now let's add the sixth chord. So a sixth chord uses what's called a 9 semitone. And I'm saying semitone, and I say 9 because I want to separate that from a ninth th at the end. That's a scale degree, is a ninth. So you're going to see a lot of chords like major 7 or major add 9. They get really lazy when it comes to scale degrees, unfortunately, because that can confuse people when it comes to this type of chord code strategy. That's why I teach music theory the way I do. Okay, so in this case, it's going to be the same exact triad. So we're going to copy this over because that's a major triad. A 3-note chord means triad. So it's 0-1-2-3-4-5-6-7. So it's 0-4-7. When you play all those semitones together, you get a major chord. Now, the difference between a major chord and a sixth chord is that we're adding the sixth to the chord and we're leaving out the seventh. So to do that, we're going to use chord code. So it's 0-4-7-9. So the top note should be 9. So in this case, we have 0-4-7, but we need a note at 8-9. We need to pull this top note down. So this is what it sounds like if we were to just use the same root note, which sounds cool. But again, the technique I'm showing you is to transpose this chord up. So it's still a sixth chord, but I'm just hitting shift up until the top notes match. Okay, and it pulls up the energy. This is really good for guitar players because, again, when you play guitar, you have to use certain voicings. And this is more common in guitar language and R&B, but I want to bring it to you in hip-hop as well in R&B. So with this, okay, so it's 0-1-2-3-4-5-6-7-8-9. So it's 0-4-7-9. It will always make a sixth chord. That's why I said it derives from a major chord, because it has a major triad. Okay, so that's how we separate the sixth chord from, you know, minor sevenths and major sevenths and all that type of stuff. Okay, so now let's copy the same chord, which is our major 7. Let's pull that over to the right. And now I'm going to use a chord to wrap up this chord progression that I learned from MG the Future, or he pointed out and made aware to me, which is called a 6-add-9 chord. So in order to do this, we have to copy our sixth chord over, which is this chord here. And we need to add a chord extension called a ninth th. Okay, scale degree, a chord extension called a ninth. Now we can do this with chord codes, so it makes it less convoluted. So chord codes give us the exact values to add in. So it's 0, 4, 7, 9, 14. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Now we just have to tell the plugin which note we want to end on. So it's, I want to end on this note here, which is A sharp or B flat. So we're just going to transpose the whole thing down, hit shift down until that's the top note. Okay, so notice there's a lot of notes in common. Okay, so that's the power of these chord codes. Let me crank this up a little bit. So the Hermes synth has a lot of sounds in it. You can go to www.hermesplugin.com to learn more about it. Okay, so that's the Drake sound. And then you can add the sixth add nine chord at the end to make it feel like it's moving somewhere. So notice how there's not a lot of movement in the notes, but it sounds like it's moving. So that's the trick to it, is using the top notes, keeping those similar, and then also using that sixth chord as an in-between chord to make those major chords mesh together. So that's a technique. If you want to learn more, just go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory. We have a ton of free training for you. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory. And you also get a free chord code chart to download straight to your phone, so you have those chord codes as a reference. So thank you for watching today. It's Game from busyworksbeats.com.